What's up, guys? Joe Holland here. I am fishing with my good buddy Jack today, and we are on a wild Maine native brook trout kick today. We are going to fish the state's smallest pond. We call it the tiniest wild native brook trout pond. It's called Blue Hole. We're down in southern Maine, and this pond is tiny. It is 134,000 square inches. And we're gonna be able to cover it all in one day. We came in last night to check and make sure there was ice. We hiked in and took my axe and chipped away and found that there was not a lot of ice, not a lot of safe ice. So we're taking extra precautions today. We have a rope out on the ice, and we have these pegs right here. So that way, if we do fall through or break through, we're gonna have to get out. We're not gonna be able to fish it very long. I'm guessing we got maybe an hour to fish it before the ice starts weakening and giving way. It's really milky.
That's why we're checking it today.
Weak ice. It's not the good hard black ice that has strength to it. This is the stuff that's very unpredictable. So we brought in a sled. We brought in the ice tent, not for ourselves as much as for the viewing, because this is, we're going to try to sight fish these things. Yeah. And you get a lot better view if you make it darker above the hole that you cut, and hopefully the cameras will be able to pick up the fish too. But we don't really know if there's brookies in here. We're just kind of guessing. So we're hoping they're in here, and it's fed by two little feeder brooks that are still wide open. But what happens is the brook trout in the winter come out of those brooks into any pond or lake they can get into, and this happens to be the only pond on these brooks. State law allows us to keep five brookies over 6 inch. We're just catch and release today. If they're in there at all, we don't really want to take any or hurt this little pond. We just want to have some fun, catch some fish, and see what these little tiny native brookies look like. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Come along. I think it's going to be a great day. You're either going to catch us falling in, or you're going to see us catch some, or you're going to see us zero. Tiniest trout pond in Maine right there, bud. Now we gotta get down that hill without killing ourselves and breaking all the gear.
I'm riding it.
You don't think you'll break the gear? Okay, I'll video.
I need to make sure the chest mount's going.
You're gonna get hurt.
Oh, wait, there's a pond. The pond's right there.
Yeah. I'd consider going down backwards. Just walk it down so we don't break the gear.
Yeah, but
you're gonna dump it. You'll either dump it or hit a tree.
Or a bale.
Yeah, but what about the gear?
Keep my feet in snow. I got a trick shot right there that isn't gonna fall. Do it.
What do you want to do?
I'm young. I gotta take it down that.
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking on a scale of 1 to 10 on this being a good idea, we're around
2.
Two.
Yeah, I was thinking 2.
But it's entertaining, so that's like
yeah,
a
no
11.
Matter what, it's going to be entertaining. Just yeah. If we don't break any stuff, including my bones, we're yeah. good. It's a win. I
exactly.
Think. If I wipe out, we'll get shit.
Plus, you got all this fishing line dragging behind you, so that'll slow you down.
Yeah. That 3-pound test will probably actually
that
work as a pretty
you.
Good anchor.
Hold
yeah.
you up. It's like bungee jumping. So what's the plan here, Jeff? Where are you heading?
So you see that little gap in those trees.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to probably veer either right or left. I'll see which way Mother Nature takes me to avoid that pine tree with that tree in the middle there.
Okay, you think you're
going to
make it
left? If I'm going left, I'm going to have to bail and not break the ice through the pond.
Okay. Oh, so you're planning on going all the way?
I'm not going to go to the pond.
Okay.
We got brook trout to catch.
I'm pretty sure you won't make it to the pond. But
I would. I would much rather do this head first, but I got to get this on foot.
Holy.
Oh, are you real?
Oops.
Jesus, that was a bad. Oh, look at that backlash. No broken tips, just a broken, two broken reels. Well, this one's not broken. All right.
I'm thinking back, good idea or bad idea?
Probably bad idea.
Yeah. Tree always wins.
Check the phone. Phone's good.
Oh, you had your phone?
Yeah.
Nice. All right, we're almost there. I'd say don't ride it the rest of the way. No. Came in yesterday, cut these holes to check for ice. The ice is super sketchy. Maybe 3 inches of terrible white milky ice. But we cut some holes, spread some water on top so it would get a chance to freeze a little bit stronger. And hopefully it strengthened up a little bit since last night.
Nice work, yes.
Perfect. Good job.
Yeah, I might have lost a reel too.
Oh no.
No rods, but two reels broke.
Yeah. Well, we made it.
Yeah.
We should have taken the rods out before you did that.
Yeah. I said on the other one, I was like, should I leave the rods in? I was like, nah, I don't want to go back up the hill again.
Oh, it cracked pretty good. Do you hear that?
Broke.
Oh. She's cracking pretty good. She's crack-a-lacking, Jack. Safety wise, we have our spikes on. These things pull apart and have spikes in case I fell through. And then we tied a rope to a tree. As you could see, we tied a rope to a tree and ran it right into the shack where we were fishing. So that way, if we fell through, and for some reason, if we couldn't hit bottom, which we should be able to, then we could pull ourselves out. But it's, you know, it's about 5 to 6 foot. So it is over your head or close to it. It's not good ice. Anyway, I'll show you what the ice looks like. It's a good solid 2 inches probably. So there it is right there. Probably 2 inches. Well, actually no, maybe an inch. It's as thick, it's about as thick as my thumb. And, oh geez, that just went down. Let me get off the ice. And then it's not really good hard black ice. It's milky white. This is bad. This is not good, guys. Don't ever really trust this ice, okay, if you're over your head or on a big lake or anything like that. What you're looking for is good, hard, black ice. This is not good. This is milky clear, and it doesn't have the strength that good, hard, black ice has.
Hopefully there's some trout in here.
Who knows?
Oh, I saw a fish. Yeah, I do see him. Yeah, he's right there. Oh. Lift it around. Lift it up. Lift it up.
Get him. Get
him. Miss him. He's got you.
Oh God.
Get your hands wet, get your hands wet. They're already wet. That was awesome, dude. It's actually broken. Got that wall on the camera, that was so cool. They're still in here, they're still in here, baby. Don't let me swim.
Pretty sure the camera. Guys, a little pencil brookie.
Oh, dude, I got one.
Oh, there we go. Oh, awesome. Got him.
Yes.
Nice one. Wow. That's actually a keeper, believe it or not. Look at that one, guys. What a beauty, huh? Beautiful colors on them.
Got him.
Yeah. Oh, man. Look at how small he is. Another one, guys. Tiny, tiny native.
I'll switch. You see what I'm doing? Like, I'm kind of lifting it.
Yeah.
up. Yes, baby, look at the size of that one. Oh, he popped off, I got him. Look at the size of that one, Jack. Thank you for letting me know he was there. That's a big one, dude. That's a big one for a little tiny, tiny spot like this.
9.5
Is that lined up good?
Yep.
Yeah, 9.5
9.5 9.75
Here we go.
I want to get a video.
Want to weigh it?
Yeah.
Do you want to?
No. The other one was bigger.
The one you just missed?
Yeah. Guys, this is the biggest one we've landed yet. He's 9.5 inches, super native, super, super pretty fish. These things are unbelievable. They're hard to catch. But now, look how pretty that is. You got him on yours?
Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful fins on him. And we're gonna get him back. See if he knows how to get back.
I'm looking at this hole on there.
That was awesome.
That's amazing.
Sorry to do you dirty on your lure like that.
Yeah, that's funny.
That was dirty.
Sorry. Are those big ones, they're bull rushing that?
They're bull rushing it. Did you see how I'm just sitting there? I'm moving it this much, but I'm moving it a million times like this. Look, I'm just doing that.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. He's new. Hey. Got him. That was awesome. He came flying in.
Yeah, I had that on me. On my camera.
Really?
Yeah. Jesus, dude, I can't catch
you. Maybe you're too close to the camera. Another one. Beautiful brook trout. Look at these things, dude. They got the stripes on them when they're small.
Yeah.
The tiger trout.
Little Maine tiger trout.
I'm on fire, Jack.
You do.
I just got the hot hand today.
I guess. The hot spot.
Yeah, maybe it is just away from that camera.
I'll turn the jig further.
We can throw the camera on this side, but I'm not walking over there. I don't want to move now. I'm worried about falling through right now.
Me too.
So lures for today. This is one of my absolute favorite little brook trout lures. I think this one's made by 13 Fishing. I don't know what they call it, but I call it a mini or baby rattle trap because that's basically what it is or what it's emulating. So it looks like a little tiny bait fish. And this one is gold on one side, silver on the other, which, whatever. I like it because it's gold and it's shiny, and it's got a little tiny rattle and it makes noise. And it's the right size for brook trout. So it looks like a bait fish, and it makes vibrations, make noise, and it's shiny. So fish like shiny things. So that's one of my favorite little brook trout baits. I've used that for big brook trout too, and for little ones, it's just kind of fitting for them. That thing was pretty hot today. Caught a handful on that. And then I figure there's no shiners in this little tiny pond. So most of the stuff these fish are eating in the winter are like bugs and nymphs and whatever is moving, basically. I thought they'd be a little more aggressive, but I think we spooked the fish and they're really spooky with us showing up. They weren't crazy aggressive, but the other bait is this little tiny tungsten jig with, I believe it's a clam that I cut in half, and it just looks like a nymph or some kind of worm or caddis shuck or something weird. So that's the other one there, just to have for a little bit difference. Hard to hook these fish because they hit so quick and they spit so quick unless you have treble hooks. Just to let you guys know who don't live in Maine, and even if you live in Maine, brooks and streams are closed to ice fishing usually by October, and you're not allowed to ice fish them at all, or even open water fish them if you can. Like, I come in here and make a cast here, but it's not legal. We actually called the warden service to make sure that it was legal to fish here, because if it's not in the book, most things apply to general law if it's not in the book. But we also wanted to clarify if this was actually a pond or just the brook. To us, it looks like a very tiny pond, so we called. The warden service transferred us through, like, four or five people. And then finally they transferred us to somebody in here. We got an officer who said he knew it really well, said as long as you're not on private property, then you won't have a problem. If you're on private property, somebody's gonna ask you to leave. So this is actually public land. There's a hiking trail right here. This is the smallest actual pond in the state of Maine, especially with native brook trout. Thanks for tuning in today, guys. Had an awesome day catching some of these native Maine brookies on a pond that I probably guarantee has never been ice fished before. I think some guys hike in here. There's a hiking trail and maybe open water fish it. I found a bobber in the tree, so I'm guessing people have been in here before. It's no secret because the interstate is right there. Zoom, as you can see behind me. So it's not really a secret. We heard a couple cars maybe skid a little bit when they saw the shack, when they looked over, because I'm sure nobody's ever had a shack on this thing either. It was really fun catching these native Maine brook trout in their environment. They come down into these little pools, or what we call ponds, for the winter, because the streams and brooks will freeze a lot of times, and or even dry out. But the trouble they're facing, and the thing I was really worried about when I got here, was there's a ton of otter tracks coming off the banks around the snow, and an otter can get in these little tiny ponds like this and just clean them out if there's a couple otter especially working together. And that's why we're not catching anything huge. One, the environment won't really sustain anything huge, but two, the bigger brook trout are slower, they're easier targets, and they're bigger targets for the otters, and the otters get in here and just wipe it out. I gotta believe in this little tiny pond right here there's probably 50 native brook trout wintering in here. We saw a handful of different schools today. One school had 14, one maybe 20, and then a handful of schools that had like anywhere from 4 to 10 in it. They know this pond because they live here every day. This pond, if you get on a tiny pond like this, they're gonna know you're here. So that's why we tried to be as quiet as we could. We spooked them a bunch of times just by moving our feet or Jack's chair or even talking. So that's why a lot of it was whispering. And we tried not to move, because actually a couple times just moving like our heads and looking over, a couple of them darted away. So definitely a closed environment for these fish, and that's what made them so hard to catch. And they were really difficult to catch, and they never really sat under the hole for any significant amount of time unless they were actually there to feed. You know, they just kind of cruise through and cruise through and cruise through and keep moving, which is what most native brook trout do anyway.
Hold on there, Jack. Hold on there, Jack. Yank it back. I'm going down. Oh, tree.
I think that's a little bit. This is the brook that feeds that pond. One of them.
Yeah, definitely.
So those brookies will make it all the way up here.
Oh yeah, it's springtime. Yeah. Even fall with the rain.
Yeah.
Probably gonna come back.
Yeah. Here, jump across with the front.
A lot easier than a freaking shack.
You dropped your sticker. You're gonna wipe out, dude.
You think?
Oh yeah. No doubt.
Trust me. Oh, I'm wet.
Was it worth it? I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna be a cool video.
Yeah, it was fun. Dude, we caught brookies.
Yeah.